Hello everyone, we have seen in the class how a discrete time system is represented by a linear constant coefficient difference equation along with few auxiliary conditions. In this lecture, we will see a problem on solving for difference equations in order to obtain the total response of the discrete time system for a given input. So, let us consider a problem. So, the system given here is represented by a linear constant coefficient difference equation, which is y of n minus 5 by 6 y of n minus 1 plus 1 by 6 y of n minus 2 is equal to x of n, with the initial conditions y of minus 1 is equal to 1 and y of minus 2 is equal to 0. It is asked to find out the total response of the system when the given input x of n is equal to 2 power n into u of n. Now, the total response of the system y of n, it contains two parts. The first part is called as homogeneous solution and the second part is called as particular solution. The homogeneous solution y h of n is obtained by keeping x of n is equal to 0 in the difference equation. So, the right hand side of the difference equation will become 0 when we are trying to find out y h of n. So, let us make the right hand side of the equation 0 and rewrite the equation. It is now y of n minus 5 by 6 into y of n minus 1 plus 1 by 6 into y of n minus 2 equal to 0. So, there is only one signal which is going to satisfy this equation. The signal is y of n is equal to a lambda power n. If you substitute that in this equation, y of n is a into lambda power n minus 5 by 6 into y of n minus 1 is a into lambda power n minus 1 plus 1 by 6 into y of n minus 2 is 1 by 6 into lambda power n minus 2. There is a missing here. There is a into lambda power n minus 2. If I put it outside, this is lambda square minus 5 by 6 into lambda plus 1 by 6. If you multiply this with this, you will get back to this equation. So, if you factorize this, this is lambda minus half into lambda minus 1 by 3 is equal to 0. So, the values of lambda 1 and lambda 2 are half and 1 by 3, and the homogeneous solution is given by c1 into 1 by 2 whole power n plus c2 into 1 by 3 whole power n. Let us move to the next thing. So, the next part of the problem will be finding out the particular solution. To find out the particular solution will be of the same form of the input given x of n is equal to 2 power n into u of n. So, yp of n, we will assume that k into 2 power n into u of n. In order to find out k, we need to substitute this yp of n in the given difference equation. So, let us do that. I am substituting yp of n is equal to k into 2 power n u of n in the difference equation. So, it is y k into 2 power n u of n, this is y of n minus 5 by 6 into this, you have y of n minus 1 if you remember. So, this is k into 2 power n minus 1 into u of n minus 1 plus 1 by 6 into this is y of n minus 2. So, in place of y of n minus 2, I am substituting k into 2 power n minus 2 into u of n minus 2. So, this has to be equal to 2 power n into u of n, which is equal to x of n. Now, this equation, if you see, this has u of n minus 2 term in this. So, in order to find out what is the value of k here, we need to make a fundamental assumption that n is greater than or equal to 2. Because for any other value of n, if you see here, n minus, as n minus 1 and n minus 2 are present, these values, these terms are going to become 0. So, if you want to find out the true value of k, you have to assume that n is greater than or equal to 2. So, when I assume n is greater than or equal to 2, then the all the step functions will become 1. So, k into 2 power n minus 5 by 6 into 1 by 2 k into 2 power n plus 1 by 6 into k into 2 power n multiplied with 1 over 4 is equal to 2 power n. This 2 power n is common with all. So, I am putting it outside and I am summing up the remaining terms here, which is going to give me k is equal to 8 by 5. So, I am substituting that in the total response y of n is equal to y h of n plus y p of n. This is equal to y h of n is nothing but c1 into 1 by 2 whole power n plus c2 into 1 by 3 whole power n plus the particular solution 8 by 5 into 2 power n u of n minus 2. Now, the next thing is to find out what is the value of c1 and c2. How to find out the value of c1 and c2? We already know. So, to find out the c1 and c2, we use the auxiliary conditions. The auxiliary conditions which are given are y of minus 1 is equal to 1 and y of minus 2 is equal to 0. So, if you put n is equal to minus 1 in this expression y of n is equal to 1 if I, y of n is equal to minus 1 if I put, this will now become c1 into 1 over 2 whole power minus 1 plus c2 into 1 over 3 whole power minus 1, 8 by 5 into 2 power n u of n minus 2 when n is equal to minus 1 is u of minus 3. So, this part is going to become 0. So, this is 2c1 plus 3c2 is equal to 1, and this is the, let us say this is the equation number 1, and if we continue and let us put y of let us put n is equal to minus 2 to find out what is the value of y of minus 2, it is given that the value is equal to 0. So, if you put n is equal to minus 2 in that expression, this is what we are going to get, and if you solve for this equation c1 is equal to minus 9 over 4 multiplied with c2 is what we got. Let us substitute this in equation number 1. If you substitute that in equation number 1, the values of c1 and c2 we can find out. The value of c2 is minus 2 over 3 and the value of c1 is 3 over 2. So, I am substituting this in the total response, which is going to give you the actual answer. So, y of n is equal to 3 by 2 into 1 over 2 whole power n plus minus 2 over 3 into 1 over 3 whole power n plus 8 by 5 into 2 power n u of n minus 2. If we do with the 0 input response and 0 state response, how we are going to find out? So, 0 input response is this. 0 input response, if you want to find out, we have to make that x of n is equal to 0. So, if you put x of n is equal to 0 and follow the same process, we will have a homogeneous solution again, which is given by yz of n is equal to c1 into 1 over 2 whole power n plus c2 into 1 over 3 whole power n. Now, the difference between this and the previous case is, here we are going to obtain c1 and c2 values by substituting y of minus 1 and y of minus 2 values here itself, not at the total response stage. Okay? So, if you substitute that y of minus 1 is equal to 1, this is c1 into 1 over 2 whole power minus 1 plus c2 into 1 over 3 whole power minus 1, this has to be equal to 1, and y of minus 2 equal to 0. If you do the same process, to be frank, actually these equations are same as the previous case, and you will get c1 is equal to 3 over 2 and c2 is equal to minus 2 over 3. So, the 0 input response is same as the homogeneous solution you got, and moving further, you can see the 0 state response we can obtain by taking y of n, the total response we have to compute, and then we have to use y of minus 1 equal to 0, y of minus 2 equal to 0. That means, I am making both the initial conditions as 0. So, that will simply give me c1 is equal to 0 and c2 equal to 0. So, what that particularly means is that the particular solution is going to become the 0 state solution. So, it is very interesting that in this case, the 0 state solution is same as the particular solution, and 0 input response or 0 input solution is nothing but your homogeneous solution. So, you can see again the total response is same as the previous case. So, I'll